what you see. A bunch of nonsense on my TV. Heaven on earth is what I need. When I feel I'm in hell every time I breathe. Pour life from the outside, what you hear. A bunch of nonsense all in my ear. Rich man, poor man, we all gotta pay. It's freedom ain't free, especially around my way.
Good morning, good afternoon, good night. This your boy Nonsense Nap here. And in today's video, I'll be bringing you a One Piece theory that consists of who I believe to be the traitor of the Nine Red Scabbards. Now, it's been a lot of speculation on who people think the traitor is. I done heard it was the big sheep dude, the monkey, Raizo, Shinobu, Carrot. You know what I'm saying? But I got somebody. I've been saying it for a minute. I'm my boy, the Grand Shogun Channel. You can check him out. We do live reactions and discussions about the recent chapters of One Piece. You know what I'm saying? Check him out. I've been discussing this with my boys, Kozuki, Oden on Twitter, the Black Rob Lucci and Vulture Valley. You know, they know the theory. And they telling me, you know, I could be a little crazy. Hypebeast Morgans told me I was reaching, okay? But you know what? I think I got enough conclusive evidence to say why this individual is the traitor. So I'm going to go ahead and get into it, man. So, you know, you got nine scabbards. I added one more, Ben Shinobu, because people consider her, you know, a part of the squad, you know. But I don't think Shinobu was somebody who would betray someone. You know, she doesn't give me that vibe, right? Especially with the last couple chapters where she pretty much gave information about Oden. Said, I was up there looking down on y'all from the ceiling. I know what popped off. I know why he was doing this for everybody. I went to the war to help fight these fools, right? Saved Oden's life. I pulled up to make sure didn't nothing pop off here. You know, some stupid mess. But Oden wanted to, he out here in the bot boiling for his people. And y'all still saying he a fool of a lord? What's wrong with y'all? Somebody who gonna betray someone having that compassion? Nah, I don't see it. I don't see it. And Oden stuck up for it too? Don't seem like the type of person, right? So she X'd out the picture. It ain't Shinobu, okay? So then you got Okiku. Okiku been riding with Oden for a while, right? Now, for me, when I got five reasons why this person, more like six or seven, real talk, but five reasons, like mainly, why this person is the traitor, right? But with Okiku, and this is one of the reasons with Okiku, Okiku wore the crescent moon, what you call those things, the kimono, right? Back in a 20-year time skip, okay? So we see when Oden came back, Okiku had on the crescent moon. It was like stitched together. He had on that kimono. Now we know after this 20-year time skip, right, with Oden boiling, even then when Oden was boiling, Okiku still had the crescent moon a little fit on then too, along with another scabbard, right? But Okiku been in the Caucasus Mountains doing work, made a name for himself, the prettiest man in Wano, but also a very dangerous one at that. Didn't join sides along with the Orochi and Kaido, could have been on that squad, but didn't do it. Everybody knows him for being very skilled in the mountains, away from all the BS. I wonder why. But that's where he was at before, when Oden found him. Kind of makes sense. Got to go back to my roots. So with the fact of him wearing out in the open, pretty much professing and saying, hey, man, I'm a Kozuki clan member. I'm a part of the Scabbards. I'm wearing this with pride. I don't think Okiku is that particular type of person. I don't think they would go around betraying people. That's not enough reason for me to believe that, right? So we rule out Okiku. Then you got my boy Nekomamushi, Cat Viper. It's not him. He's not even in the story right now, right? He's not present in the story. So there's no way he can divulge information to the enemy. It's not Nekomamushi. Granted, even though, and this is my third requirement for the second requirement for the traitor. So I gave you 2 and 3. 3 is having to wear a garment or some type of cloak or on the person like itself, like a tattoo of the Kozuki clan symbol or the crescent moon, right? Number 2 is being on zone when Jack pulled up. We know Nekomamushi was there, right? But what'd he do? He said, hey, I want all the smoke. No questions asked. We don't need to talk. I'm pulling up. I'm flipping this nigga. That's what he did to Jack. And he not even present in the story because he talking to Marco. So he can't divulge information. So it's not Nekomamushi. Also, he wore a kimono as well that had the crescent moon on it. Come on, man. War with pride. You've been out here riding with Oden since jump. Complaining about the heat. From jump, right? When he was eating the food, man, I can't take it. When over there boiling with Oden, man, I can't take the heat. He been the same. It ain't him. So now we transition to Ashura Doji. Ashura Doji may have a reason. I'm trying to figure out why he got the flower tattoo like Hirogoro. Is that his son? Don't know. That's another theory for later. But for now, is he the traitor? I don't believe so. What was he doing in Oden's absence? In Curry? Doing work. Keeping order. Making sure people wasn't getting out of line. The same thing Oden was doing. Almost like being a daimyo. Could be like, well, Orochi put this man in charge. So that's why he was doing it. You do the same thing. You give us the information, this, that, and the third. We'll give you power. We'll give you back Curry, right? Possible. I don't know. But I don't think it's a. I don't think it's Ashura. You know why? Because this man got stabbed in the back when they was fighting. If he's a traitor, he ain't gonna get stabbed in the back. That don't make no sense. Unless it's a reason. But for me right now, I can't see it. Out here like Stevie, I'm blind to it. You feel me? So because of that, I gotta take him off the board, right? Now, I will apply this to Ashura as well as Shinobu. This is the number 4 reason, you know what I'm saying? The number 4 incentive that the traitor would have to have is being a part of Kozuki Oden's castle. Now, Shinobu definitely wasn't, so another reason why to take her and eliminate her out. But Ashura Doji physically wasn't there. Him and Denjiro, when Oden came back, were not present in the castle. We only saw them when they was ready to pull up on Kaido. So technically, you can say they ain't part of the castle, even though they affiliated with the Scabbards, right? So even then, I would add that to it. I'm like, you know what? It ain't Ashura. So then we transition to Kaomatsu, somebody that was at the castle. Right, and we know that for a fact because Kinemon expressed to Oden how Lady Toki got hurt was because a man and his family decided not to join Kaido and Orochi in working at the factory. Once they got killed, we said enough is enough. We gonna go there and we gonna handle our business. But in the meantime, we gotta make sure these people here are safe. Kaomatsu and Arashi protect Lady Toki and company. Evidently, they didn't do a good job. Because somebody was able to work their way inside and get a shot off on Momonosuke. And if not for his loving mother to protect her child, Momo would not be with us today. But for me, that makes it seem like there was a traitor in the midst. You allow somebody to get that close. There's nobody on Kaido's crew at that time besides Kaido himself, King, Queen, and Jack. That could have got past Kaomatsu and Inarashi. I don't believe none of these other washed up, what's my man's name with the lion or the elephant? They're not enough. Definitely not enough, right? And I don't think King, Queen, or Jack pulled up over there. And maybe Queen because of the arrows and stuff, poison arrows and whatnot. But, it's not enough for me. So I put an asterisk next to Kawamatsu and Inarashi. Suspicious. Suspicious activity there. But Kawamatsu, we know he got here by Fishman, right? Who else is a Fishman? On Kaido's crew, Jack, right? So would you think that possibly the story of Kawamatsu is wrong? He lied. Jack is actually his brother in some form or fashion. Because we know all Fishmen don't look the same. Have the same mom, same dad, but you get different outcomes. It's very possible. But he also wore a kimono. He also took care of Hiyori after Odin's death. Then got locked up. I don't think it's Kawamatsu. It would give reason, but I don't think it was Kawamatsu. Not at this moment in time. So we X him out the picture. We're exiting Kawamatsu out the picture. I'm going to give you a quick recap. I'm going to do a part one. This is part one, end of part one. I'm going to do a part two. Okay, two videos, drop them out today, same day, right? So just quick recap. You got number five. You had to be a part of Odin's backstory 20 years ago. Number four had to be affiliated with Odin's castle. So that now eliminates Shinobu. And then we put two asterisks by Asha Doji and Denjiro. I'm going to get to Denjiro on the next one, but definitely by Asha Doji. So we rule Asha Doji out, you know, because he got stabbed in the back. So then we transition to number three, which is you have to have a garment affiliated with the Kozuki clan symbol or the crescent moon or essentially a tattoo or a marking of some kind that says the Kozuki clan crest, right? So for right now, if we look at these five individuals, Shinobu's out because she's not affiliated with the castle. Asha Doji's out because he's not affiliated with the castle. Also got stabbed in the back. Kiku's out because he wore a garment, right? As well as Nekomamushi, right? Kawamatsu. So everybody here has at least some, at some point, you know, could be a part of the traitor talk. But once you get to that third mark, it's like, nope. Well, they had that on them. Whoever the traitor is would not have worn any garment associating themselves with such, because it has to be a sign of loyalty in there at some point in some form or fashion. So that's part one. Let me know down in the comments below if y'all think I'm just wilding on this theory right now. If y'all still consider someone out of these five, you know, let me know down in the comments below what y'all thoughts are. Who do you consider to be the traitor at this point in time? Like the video, share the video, please. That helps grow the channel. Again, drop a comment. Part two coming up next. I always remember, can't take a bad nap. Peace.